Here's number two on the similar figures and circles review. First thing I want to do is make sure that if I have similar figures that I label things that are corresponding, so sides that correspond or match. The way I see this is that I have a small triangle here, and then I have this much larger triangle here. I notice that the triangle has three different side lengths. We have a short side, we have a middle side or medium, and then we have the longest side. That same thing is true about the large one. I've gone ahead and colored pink the short side. So the short side of my other, the larger triangle, will also correspond or match. And then I would also say that this middle or medium sized length matches up with also the medium sized length of this larger triangle. And lastly, we have the hypotenuse, which is the longest side length of a triangle, and the longest side length of that larger triangle. So I've color coded, which means now I can start to think about setting up proportions. The issue here is I don't have any numbers, but in my problem, I do. Anytime you're given a picture and the numbers are in your problem, go ahead and transfer those numbers into the problem. It says EF, which measures here, is 10. It says DF, which is down here in green, is 16. And then DH is 48. And D, all the way to H, that's 48. Then it wants to know what is the length of GH. So we're looking for this length in pink. It's nice because I already know what matches together, and that can be part of my labels. I'm going to have information about a big triangle in this first ratio, and I'm going to go ahead and have information about the small triangle in the second ratio. You can flip-flop it if you want, and your labels won't matter as long as you have labels, okay, reasons for putting numbers in certain places. So I'm going to pick a number from the big triangle, and I'll go ahead and use 48. Okay, that's in green. I'll put that here. Looking also at the small triangle, what number corresponds with that? Well, it's the 16, because again, they're both in green. They're both also the medium length side. Both of these are green, so I can label that green if I want to. And then the other color I need to use is pink. The black doesn't matter because the black doesn't give me any information, but I am going to use pink. So the 10 comes from the small triangle. That information is a small triangle. That belongs here. And then my unknown is part of my big triangle. That goes there. And I'll label that pink. Both of these numbers are highlighted in pink. Both of those numbers are highlighted in green. Now I can start to solve. First thing is look for a shortcut. If for whatever reason you don't see a shortcut, you can think about simplifying some things. But the good news is I see that this can be multiplied by 3. 16 times 3 is 48, which means I can also multiply that by 3. My shortcut is also called my scale factor. Okay, times 3 is my scale factor, meaning each of these numbers have been multiplied by 3 to make this larger triangle. So 10 times 3 is 30. My missing side length is 30 centimeters.